see? It's Todd Guy, the Thrash and Jump Zombie. This is a contest entry for Nathan over at Metal Downunder. He's got four, kind of five questions. Four is a two-part question. What is this for? 2 years, I think, in the VC, he said. He's a heavy metal guy. He likes the thrash and some power metal, I think. And yeah. I have to say, though, I do have to put subtitles on sometimes because I have trouble understanding him. But that's probably just me. You know, he still shows some great albums. So, said he did. Yeah, he entered my contest, so I'm gonna enter him. He's got some cool questions here, so before we start, we're listening to Blue Oyster Specters back there, if you can hear it, like I always say, I don't know if you can. But anyway, the first question he's got is, name a song you can't stand. It took me a little while to think about that. There are some songs I can't stand, but I can't really think of anything, and there's one that I really, really can't stand. It's not because it's a bad song, per se. It just has some bad memories attached to it. And that is Heart Alone. My ex was a fairly big Heart fan, and that was like her favorite song. And she had this live CD of Heart, and she would play that song over and over and over again. And I can't listen to actually any Heart song now without thinking of that and just making me nauseous because of that. So, I'm not saying Heart's a bad band. They're not a bad band. I can't hear her voice, the singer, I can't remember her name, of any song without feeling nauseous and anxious because of my ex. So, which is kind of crappy because, I mean, I used to like Heart, but now I can't listen to them. So Heart Alone is that song I can't stand. Not because it sucks, just because of the emotional response I get from it. If I want to get technical about a song I can't really stand, Britney Spears, song. Any song by Britney Spears, basically. Oops, I Did It Again. I can't stand that song. Baby Hit Me One More Time. Terrible. But, okay. On to the next question. Number two is, name a song you never tire of. This song, it's from this album, Flotsam and Jetsam's No Place for Disgrace. The song is Escape from Within. I first heard this album, and I heard that song. It just resonated with me, and it just stuck with me forever. I love that song. I can listen to that song every day. It just starts off kind of slow, and then it gets heavy near the end. It's great. Number three, an album you have on multiple formats. I have a few that I have on cassette. Actually, I feel I have on vinyl and CD, but I'm going totally with what I have on vinyl, CD, and cassette. Excuse me. I have two. First one is Seven Mary 3, American Standard. I'm on all three, cassette, CD, and vinyl. And then the second one, my favorite album of all time, Tesla's The Great Radio Controversy. So, yeah. The vinyl, I'll never get rid of. Cassette, I'll probably never get rid of, because I'll probably never find one again. Sorry. I'm very flummy today. Let me get a drink. Oops. Okay, number four, this is a two-part question. A great lockdown song. Now this, I guess, can be interpreted a couple of ways for lockdown. Is it a song about being in a lockdown? Or is it a song that has to do with what's going on in the world while you're in lockdown? Or is it just a song that you like a lot you can listen to every day while in lockdown? So, it didn't really... I don't know. I picked two songs that have to do with what's kind of going on in the world. You might call me a madman because of one of these songs, or actually both of these songs. The first one is, don't take offense to this, from this album, Tempo of the Damned, Culling the Herd, by Exodus. I'm not gonna get into why I picked this song. It's just, Culling the Herd. And then the other one is from this song, or from this album, Elimination. Some of the lyrics are just like what's going on. What's that cough and wheeze? Fatal, you're shitting me. Yeah. So Elimination and Culling the Herd are two great lockdown songs about what's going on in the world, basically. This is written in 87. This came out in 87, right? Oh, 89. And the Tempo of the Damned was like 99. So, but still, don't think I'm a jerk and I care and I want people to die or anything. It's just, I have a sick, twisted mind sometimes. Okay, and the second part of that is a great lockdown movie or movie franchise or TV series. So, I'm a sci-fi fan, sci-fi movies, TV shows, good sci-fi, you know. But I also like Godzilla movies. I could have picked Godzilla movies because there's like 30 of them. But I don't have any of those on DVD or anything. Actually, I do, but I decided to go with this instead. Stargate. Now, for all of you who know this movie and that's it, there was a show. So this came out in... when was this? 1994. And it was a pretty big hit. I mean, it had Kurt Russell in it, and this guy I hate here, what's his name? James Spader. Can't stand that guy. Okay. So, a few years later, I think it was 98 or 99, Showtime took this concept, created a show, hour-long show, called Stargate SG-1, which ran for 10 years, 10 seasons, okay, and expanded on this whole movie. Because this movie, they only thought it was just one, Stargate went to one place and back, and that was it. And the Stargate SG-1, they expanded that, and there's hundreds or thousands of Stargates across our galaxy, connecting Earth and all these other planets, and aliens that take over bodies, and it was insane. 10 seasons it ran, okay? And then there was a spinoff called Stargate Atlantis that ran for 5 seasons that sent people to a different galaxy with different Stargates, different aliens, different problems. And then another spinoff called Stargate Universe, which ran for 2 seasons, that put these people on this ship that was going across the universe. And they had problems, and the ship was breaking down and stuff. And they stopped at other planets with Stargates. They had new threats. So, in total, 17 seasons worth of Stargate stuff to watch. Now, I think this was streaming possibly on Amazon. I don't know if it still is. The shows were on Amazon at one point. Don't know if they still are. They are on Hulu, if you're in the U.S. Because I know Hulu's not anywhere else besides the U.S. If you're in the U.S., Hulu has all the Stargate, SG-1, Atlantis, and Universe. Oh, there's also two other movies, Stargate SG-1, Continuum and The Arc of Truth. Arc of Truth, actually both of those, clean up any dangling plot points from the show. So, 17 seasons of Stargate and 3 movies to watch. That's more than enough content to last you a month of watching. And also, there's the Godzilla movies you can watch, which I've been doing as well. 30-something movies of Godzilla, going all the way back to 54. And the latest one was a couple years ago, called Shin Godzilla. If you're not a Godzilla fan, you should watch Shin Godzilla at least, because it's a little different than all the other movies. Yeah, so. Anyway, that is my contest entry for Nathan over at Metal Downunder for his 2-year in the VC contest, I think it was. So, everybody stay safe, keep washing your hands. I know in the U.S. we're getting pretty close, I think, to an actual lockdown. Because U.S. loves to be number one in everything, and we certainly are number one in this as well, of confirmed cases and deaths, I think, at this point. So, rock on, stay safe.